The one central research question of our study was determining what are the consequences of certain types of human activity on bighead and silver carp establishment potential in Lake Michigan. Lake Michigan, it's already struggling to support crayfish populations. Well, now what if you introduce a superior competitor? The fear is if it could really get a foothold, it could cause potentially severe issues in regards to the fishery that's already struggling. The concern with these species is them coming through the Illinois River, and so there's several different preventive actions that are being done. There's targeted harvesting, so they're trying to keep the populations down, as well as near Joliet, Illinois, there's a huge electric barrier that deters fish movement across it, and so that's one of the stronger barriers between where the fish are and the lake. We know that they're a threat of being introduced because they're pretty close to the lake right now. We know that they could be impactful if they were able to survive here. The question then became, can they survive here? And so what this model was intended to do was answer, well, can they survive here? How well can they survive here? And what are we doing as humans to improve or reduce the vulnerability of the lake to these fishes? We looked at specifically the presence of invasive mussels, the zebra mussel and the quagga mussel, which were introduced through maritime commerce and became really prevalent and known in the late 80s, early 90s, as well as the management of phosphorus pollution. And then the third type of human activity or effect of human activity that we investigated is climate change. So trying to understand how climate warming could influence bighead and silver carp's ability to survive and grow in the lake. Some people believe that the mussels already came in and have essentially filtered out all the plankton that these fish require to grow and survive. We addressed that and said that's actually not currently the case. These fish are much more hardy and can flexibly feed on not only plankton, but also any kind of decaying organic matter that they can derive energy from. The hope is that with this risk assessment research, it informs decision makers understanding like the cost and benefits in enacting certain preventative actions, you know, understanding that establishment is possible given what our model suggests. This research is important because it makes more of an explicit link about how our management and behavior of ecosystems affects those ecosystems that we're a part of